Welcome back from that break. Now let's get to meet a star of the week in motocross rider in Jeremiah Mwanda, who races in the MX-65.
My name is Mwanda Jeremiah. I am 11 years old. I go to Homisda Lane Primary School and I am in P6. I ride in 65cc. I started writing in 2016 when the year's ending. At home, sometimes I was bored. My father could buy for my bike. One day he bought for my 50, it was a Yamaha. I started to ride. Then even I thank him for buying for me a new KTM bike. Because my father was a lorry driver, so I used to go with him. Watch him drive. Now in seeing other kids win prizes, for mom just standing, so I decided to ask him for a bike. And the problems I faced were the gears. They were somehow hard, but now I mastered them. Since I started from a 50, I came to 65 when the gears are hard, but now I've mastered them. Even I thank my coach and my parents for putting in money so that they train me every day. Even I thank my teachers. Whenever I miss work, when I go back, they teach me what they taught. My best finish so far, it is I am on the first podium, and I am sure I want to maintain it because I am above alone by 8 points. And this race is in America, watching his brother Stav Olan qualify. Now I'm going to just add on the points, and I leave him a lot. When I leave him a lot, he's going to be riding like a guest rider. This championship is too important because if I win it, I want to leave 65 when I've become a champion of it. Because it is somehow shaming to leave 65 when you're not a champion. And if you want to be a champion in other classes, you have to start from 65. In my school, I'm famous, and all the children know that I ride. When I go to the teacher and he or she gives me the notes she has taught, I get my friend's book and I copy the work he or she gave after I revise. What keeps me motivated is the training I have and the help from my coach, because last time gears were disturbing me and the way to stand. Now my coach helped me, now I'm very okay. And this race, I am expecting to get more points than before. Gift Sabuguzi has been my friend, and from school sometimes I used to go to their garage, we go to the gym. After the gym, I go back at my home, he goes back to his home. We meet on the track after we race. Even his father was friendly when he can take us to places. We can eat chicken like that. As a motocross rider, what I've got from the sport is, when you join this sport, many people like you. You become a friend to people whom even you don't know, whom you never expected to be your friends. I like Fortune because the first day I joined motocross, the mother was like, bring the child, we train with him. She was very friendly and they allowed me to train with Fortune. And it taught me some skills like to pass in the corners, to shoot jumps. After, from there, we got a coach. I expect to ride until I have my own family. Even I expect my children to ride motocross and enjoy it the way I'm enjoying it now. Out from my category, the best rider I see is Fortune Sentamu and Ali Omaya Sabobo. Those are the best riders I'm impressed in. I like Ariomar because it's friendly. When you go to the track like today and you do a mistake somewhere, he sees. When you come back like you have rested, he tells you, change there, you have did a mistake, and even you thank him. I have ever represented Uganda outside Uganda, but Zambia Lusaka is going to be my first time. When Michael chose some videos and he showed me how the track is, the track is somehow challenging, but it is almost like Busika, but the different thing on it has a lot of sand, and you can finish the whole track like standing. That's why my coach has been training me how to stand. And in Zambia Lusaka, I am expecting to be among the top 10. I represented Uganda in Nairobi, Kenya, and I was the 7th among 14 children, and it was my first race ride from outside countries.
And that was our Star of the Week. Now, next up is our sports artist, where we get to listen in on Manchester United legend N. Paul Scholes, who turned professional in 1993, making his debut for Manchester United in the 1994-95 season.
When you first arrived at Manchester United, did you ever envisage staying here as long as you have and seeing it grow as it's grown?
I never envisaged anything, really. I just came from school and wanted to play football, and wanted to try and get as high up, the teams as I could do. Obviously, starting with the U team and the A and B teams, and then going to reserves. And I just never envisaged being here for the next 17, 18 years as it has been.
You had to think about that, didn't you?
I did, yeah.
Very few players in this modern era stay with one club throughout their career. What makes you want to stay with this club for as long? Because you could have made a lot of money moving from club to club. What made you want to stay with this club and only this club?
It's the best club. I'm from Manchester. Why would I need to move? As long as I've been here and the managers want me to stay here, then that's enough for me. It's a massive club to play for. They've had so much success over the years as well that it's a no-brainer, really.
Have you ever been tempted, just a bit?
No. What's the point? It's on my doorstep. I live half an hour away from training, half an hour away from Old Trafford. It's such great players play here. There's never really been a thought or a need to play anywhere else.
Everybody wants a change, don't they, in their lives sometimes? Did you ever get bored by the routine of it?
No.
Never?
Bored of winning trophies, winning games every week. Well, most weeks. Who can get bored of that?
Well, tell me about your relationship with the manager.
I get on well with him, yeah. I think, to be here for so many years under him, then it's obviously going to be a... The odd times where you fall out a little bit, I suppose, but I get on very well with him, and if I need to speak to him, then he's always very approachable as well.
Have you ever had a row with him?
No, I don't think so. Maybe a couple of disagreements here and there, but I won't say a row, no.
I find that absolutely amazing. I do, I find that absolutely amazing. How have you managed to do that?
I'm not the type of person. I'm very, very calm. I don't need to be blazing into rows and have big disagreements. I just try and get on with playing football, and that's that.
Do you I mean, you've been here a long time, so obviously you have your opinions about how things are, and everybody who's in a job for a long time has an opinion about how things are run. Do you voice your opinion, or do you just quietly get on with the way you are?
Quietly get on with it. I think we have strong people in the team who voice their opinion if they're not happy with something, and I just tend to go along with most things, I think.
Are you a leader, or do you like to be told what to do?
Neither really. I don't know. Maybe when you say a leader, probably try and set an example in training to younger players and in games. I don't mind being told what to do, because at the end of the day you are at work and you have bosses and coaches and sort of tell you what to do, and it's your job to do that.
And that was our Sports Artist of the Week and Paul Scholes, formerly at Manchester United.